Safety is a must when enjoying the outdoors. This includes protecting yourself from tick-borne diseases. In summer, the eggs of the black-legged tick, or deer tick, hatch into six-legged larvae. Ticks are arachnids, just like spiders, but instead of spinning webs or hunting for insect prey, they quest for warm-blooded animal victims. The larvae prefer small animals like mice. They climb onto their new host and will spend days drinking its blood. This is where they can become dangerous to humans, because if the mouse is infected with the bacterium that causes Lyme disease, then the young tick will become a carrier of the pathogen. After feeding, the swollen larva will drop off and molt into the eight-legged nymph stage, which will start questing the following spring. The nymph is about the size of a poppy seed, small enough to be easily overlooked, which makes it the most dangerous life stage for humans enjoying the outdoors. Once a tick climbs onto a human host, it searches for a warm, protected spot to attach and feed. A tick's saliva contains glue to secure the tick in place while it feeds, as well as proteins that keep the blood flowing and prevent the bite from becoming painful or inflamed. Unlike the bites of mosquitoes or deer flies, tick bites do not hurt and can go unnoticed. As the tick feeds, excess liquid from the blood meal is returned to the host through the tick's saliva, along with any pathogens it may be carrying. After developing into an adult, the tick will seek its final host in the fall, usually a large animal on which it can find a mate. They prefer deer, but a human will do nicely. Adults have fed as both larvae and nymphs and are thus twice as likely to carry pathogens, but they're larger and easier to spot, so you have a better chance of removing them before they can transmit disease. The best tick removal tool is a pair of fine-tipped tweezers. Grab the tick's head as close to the skin as possible. Don't squeeze the body, as there could be bacteria or viruses inside. Then, pull the tick straight up with firm and constant pressure. You can lower the chance of bites by avoiding ideal tick habitat like brush or tall grass, and by wearing long pants, long sleeves, socks, and closed-toed shoes. Applying repellent can also make you unappealing to a waiting tick. After any outdoor excursion, check your body for ticks as soon as possible so you can remove them before they bite. This way, Lyme disease or another tick-borne illness won't be ruining your next outdoor adventure. Visit the Don't Get Ticked New York website for more detailed information on avoiding ticks and preventing bites.